Let's see how we can add in-app messaging to a React app. Now, I think the best way to understand in-app messaging is to just jump right in and take a look at a website that implements in-app messaging. Motion VFX is a company that sells VFX tools for content creators. They are currently running a sale where you get 15% off if you have more than one item in your cart. Once you add one item to the cart, you get notified that you should add another for 15%. This message right here is in-app messaging, and it can go from being as simple as how Motion VFX is using it to as powerful as creating custom notification based on a user or product attribute. With that said, by the end of this video, you'll learn how to take a shopping app and add in-app messaging to it so customers can get notified of a discount when they add a particular item to the cart. To get started, run this npx digit command to set up the starter React project if you would like to follow along. Cd into the clone starter and run npm install to install the dependencies. Once the dependencies have been installed, run npm run dev to start the app. Now the app we've just set up is a demo that generates a card that contains a positive word and allows you to shop for them. You can add the words to cart, you can increase the cart items, and you can also decrease them. There is also a cart page where you can either review the cart or update the items in the cart. You can click the select box to update the quantity of a specific item in the cart. You can also remove items from the cart here. If you find what you like in the related product section, you can also add them to the cart. The cart also has a summary section where you can review the total of items in your cart after taking tax and shipping costs into consideration. I believe we have a rough idea of what the app does, so let's take a look at what the code that powers it looks like. Open the project in your editor of choice and open the index page in the pages folder. You can see that the project is set up with Tailwind, so all the styles are inline and you can hover on them if you have the VS Code extension to show the styles used. The data is generated by randomizing a list of positive words and returning them into an array of objects. Each object has an ID, the positive word, a randomly generated color for the background of the card, and the price. I'm also caching the generated data in the local storage using a custom hook so you don't have to always generate the data every time the component that uses it renders. If we jump back to the homepage, you can see that it uses a list of cards from the data to render a product component. And if you open the cart page, you can see that it fetches a list of cards from the local storage and renders them. All the components in this project are for presentation purpose, which means they mostly take props and render data based on that props. The only exception is the product component, which adds and removes items from the cart. The cart is managed by React Use Cart, which allows you to add items to cart, remove items from the cart, and get items that are in the cart. The library knows how to keep track of our cart across different components because I wrapped the entire tree with a cart provider in the pages/app.js file. Now that's everything you need to know about the starter to follow along, but feel free to explore the rest of the project if you want to. Now that we have an idea of what our starter app is doing, let's add in-app messaging to it. Start by initializing an Amplify project using Amplify init. Now, if you don't have the Amplify CLI installed, I've linked a 5-minute step-by-step tutorial in the description that shows you how to set it up. Give the project a name and accept the default configuration. Choose your CLI's AWS profile, which you created when you set up the CLI. Running Amplify init also creates a config file in your source folder. The config file should be ignored from source control because your credentials live here. To add support for in-app messaging to your app, run Amplify add notifications. Then choose in-app messaging as the channel to enable and use the default generated name. Choose yes to allow unauthenticated users to send events since this is just a demo. Then run Amplify Push to push the notification to AWS so the services that support messaging can be provisioned for you. Confirm that you want to push and wait for the push process to complete. Now, when you pushed your Amplify app, a Pinpoint project was created for you. Pinpoint is the AWS service that Amplify uses to segment your customers and determine which type of message to show when they perform a specific action in your app. Now, before we can create a segment, you need to create a campaign for that segment. So let's go ahead and create one. Start by opening the AWS console and searching for Pinpoint. Open Pinpoint and choose the project we created from the list of projects. Head to Campaigns and click Create Campaign. A campaign is basically a set of rules you give to Pinpoint, and it follows those rules to assist you in messaging a given audience. Now, the first set of rules are about the campaign type and the type of channel you want to reach the audience through. Now, give the campaign a name, leave campaign type as standard, and then choose in-app messaging as the channel. Leave the prioritization as fairly important. Then click Next to define the next set of rules. Now, the second set of rules allows you to determine the segment of audience we talked about earlier. Now, with segmentation, you can reach a segment of your audience or customers that fit into a particular profile. So, for example, in the sample app I've built, you want to show an in-app message when a user adds a particular item to the cart. So let's say a user adds a happy card or a lucky card to the cart. We want to be able to only add discounts for those cards and nothing else in the entire app. So to create a segment, choose Create a Segment, give the segment a name, and click Next. Confirm when Pinpoint asks you if you understand that a segment might include multiple channels. Now, the next set of rules is about the actual message you want to send to the audience. You can create both the content and how you want it to look like in Pinpoint. And this is very handy because there are chances the person sending this message is not a developer, but they are responsible for sending messages to your audience or to your customers. Click the Create a New In-App Message Radio. Give the message a header. Write a more detailed message in the message box. Now you can see that as I enter the header and the message values, the preview updates to show you how it will look like when you trigger the event. You can customize this look to your taste. For example, you can change the layout so the message appears at the bottom of the screen. Click Next to move on to the last set of rules. Now, this set of rules is all about when Pinpoint should launch the campaign and also when and how it should send a message. To send a message, you need to provide an event name. When Pinpoint receives this event, it will trigger the event. You can use attribute to tell a campaign to fire only when an event attribute contains a set of information. For example, we want to only trigger this event when we either add the happy or the lucky card to cart. Add the happy adjective as an attribute. Click the Add New Attribute and add the lucky adjective as well. You need to tell the campaign when it should start. Pinpoint allows you to start the campaign as near as 15 minutes from the current time. Click Next to review your campaign and click Launch Campaign to launch it. You should see the campaign in your list of campaigns. Now we have a campaign and we've set up Amplify in our project. Let's try to tie both together so our app is set up for sending in-app messages. Install Amplify JavaScript SDK and the optional Amplify UI library. Then import the Amplify library and the Amplify config file in the app.js file. Now configure the SDK with the config object. We need to wrap the app with the in-app messaging higher order component. So the app has access to our notification setup and can send notification from anywhere in the app tree. Import the higher order component, then wrap app with it. Now run the app to ensure that everything still works as expected. When you open the app in your browser, you should see that nothing is broken. To use a custom component for the notification, import the notification component which came with the startup project. Pass the component to the components object, which you can set as the second argument for the higher order component. Now, if you want to use the default UI component that we configured in Pinpoint, you can omit the second argument but import the Amplify UI library we installed at the top of this file. Now, our app is properly configured to send messages, but before we can send any, we need to sync the messages with the customer's client. You can sync the messages anywhere in your app tree, but since we intend to trigger the message event from the product component, we can sync the messages there. Open the product component and import notifications from the Amplify library. Grab the in-app messaging object from it, and then create a use effect hook in the product component and call sync messages from in-app messaging inside the use effect hook. Now, if you head back to the browser and open the applications tab, you can see that the messages have been downloaded to your local storage and can be triggered regardless whether the user is online or offline. Now that we've synced the message, I think it's time for us to start triggering it. Now, I want a few conditions, just two conditions to be met before I trigger these messages. The first condition is that the item is not already in the cart, and the second condition is that the adjective we added to the cart matches the adjective we set in our attribute when we set up the campaign. So if that doesn't make sense, I'm just saying that if I add, we've set up happy and lucky adjective in Pinpoint, right? Now, if I add any adjective that is not lucky or happy, I don't want the campaign, or I don't want the message to be sent or to be triggered, or the event to be triggered. I only want happy or lucky to be seen or to be triggered. So only when happy or lucky is added to the cart, that's when the user sees a message that they can earn 15% discount for this particular item. We already have an if statement that checks if the item is in the cart, so we just need to dispatch the event in the else block. The dispatch event method takes an object where we can set the name of the event, and the name must match the event name we created when we created the campaign. And with that, we've passed our first condition. As for the second condition, we need to set the attribute of the event to the product's adjective. Now, anytime the product adjective matches what Pinpoint is expecting, it will trigger the event. Now head back to the browser and let's see if everything is working as expected. When I add items to the cart, nothing happens. But when I add either the lucky or the happy card to the cart, I get to see a discount notification. All right, that's how you add in-app messaging to your app. Thank you for sticking to the end of this video. See you in the next one. Bye.